God did not give us the spirit of fear. In other words, fear is a spirit. Fear is a spirit. And if God did not give us this spirit, where then does this spirit come from? The spirit of fear is a spirit of bondage. And when that spirit is at work in you, you deny your personality and you deny the power of God. If God did not give us this spirit of fear, therefore this spirit is of the devil. For God will not allow us to be afraid. Spirit of fear leads to bondage. It leads to terror. Yes, amen. It leads to anxiety, tension. If the devil is able to get a hold of your heart, he has gotten hold of your being. The devil operates through fear. Every sons and daughters of the kingdom should be bold as lions, should know how to say no to the devil. The Bible told us that when we resist the devil, he will flee. So we have the power to resist devil. When the devil is speaking, not understand and say, no, this cannot be my God speaking. Satan, get behind me. God has not given us the spirit of fear. Say boldly to yourself, I cannot be afraid. For God has not given me that spirit to fear. Hallelujah. When you are bold, when you are as bold as a lion, demons will flee before you. Powers be bowed before you. Why? You are understanding the power that is at work in you. If the spirit of fear is of the devil, then why then is he operating in believers? Why then do we fear the unknown? Why then do we fear to start life? Why then do we fear to even give hearts? Fear is captivity. When it got hold of you, it is difficult for you to liberate yourself. It takes the Holy Spirit of God. Among the fruit of the Spirit, the fruit of the Holy Spirit in Galatians 5:22, there is no spirit of fear. It is love, power. Amen. Amen. So if the Bible says God did not give us the spirit of fear, but the spirit of love, of sound mind, and power, therefore we must possess sound mind to overcome fear. We must understand the power that is at work in us to overcome fear. Amen.
Amen.
If you are the sons and daughters of a king, why do you fear as a servant?
Right on, sir. Tell us.
Why do you shiver as a servant? Why do you move as if you don't have power? If my father is a king, I should walk in the knowledge of my father being a king.
Oh, yes.
Amen.
Amen.
I cannot be a son of a king and tremble as a servant and be terrorized and terrified by the devil. We all need to grow up to one thing, that the devil literally has no power over any believer until you allow him to have power over you. Amen. He cannot manipulate you. Do you know the devil talks to every one of you in your mind? He speaks to you in your mind. He suggests to you in your mind. But those who are born of the kingdom will understand. This is the devil speaking. I will not allow him to manipulate my mind. If he gets hold of your mind, he has gotten hold of your heart. And when he gets hold of your heart, he's taking over your totality. Amen. That is why the Bible says we should be renewed and not conformed. We should be transformed and not conformed. We should be renewed up here. When our mind is renewed, the Bible says he has given us the spirit of sound mind. Amen. If your mind is sound, before the devil will be suggested, you know this is the voice of the devil. God cannot lead me in the spirit of error. God cannot tell me to go and drink. He cannot tell me to drink. He cannot tell me to womanize. He cannot tell me to kill. When you hear this voice in your mind, you understand the devil is playing with your mind.
bringing Jesus closer to all nations.